गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स. बेटा वी आर गोइंग टू डू द राइटिंग स्किल. दिस इज अ लॉन्ग राइटिंग स्किल, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वन. वन ऑफ द यू कैन से कैटेगरी ऑफ बिजनेस लेटर. फाइन, काइंडली स्विच ऑन द वीडियोस. आई कैन सी इफ यू आर राइटिंग. प्रतीक्षा, सुरवीन, गुशान, जिया, एवरी वन. बेटा यस, you need to note down. Make sure I've already given you time enough to bring your notebooks and all. Fine. So I would be discussing the format on the left side. Fine, as you can see, I have already written to save the time. On the right side, I would be telling you what to write in the content. Clear? And join well in time. See, still there are many students who have not joined so far, but we can't wait more than this. First of all, business letter, because this is a very formal letter. The way you used to write letters, the informal letters you used to write to your uncle, aunts, father, mother, that is something else. Now, business letter is one of the formal letters where you have to be very, very particular while using your language. Fine. And many a times you need to write a letter to some, you can say, suppose you want to place an order of books, then you will be writing to the manager of any publishing house or director of any publishing house. Fine. You want to place an order of any sports equipment for your school on the behalf of your school or behalf of any club you have joined, suppose, then you need to write such letters. Fine. And it can be orders, can be of anything. It can be sports goods, books, you can say musical instruments, it can be computer related accessories. These days, you know that online education is going on. People have started their businesses based on accessories. So if you want to place an order, many schools are buying computers, CCTV cameras. Fine, anything can be there in placing order. So you need to place an order. So we have to imagine that we are going to place an order with any of the company or organization or any shop. Clear? So first of all, the format. Sender's address, usually it is a 2 to 3 line address. Fine. And extreme left side of your notebook you will be writing. So you keep on noting side by side. Sender's address on left side. After sender's address, you will skip one line. You can see I have given a difference. I have not put any, I'm just going to put an arrow. Arrow doesn't mean you will be putting an arrow. Aapne arrow nahi lagana. I'm just putting an arrow as a sign that you have to leave a space here. Fine. Sender's address, then skip one line, then you will be writing date. Date will be in this format only, the way I have written on the board. Nobody will be writing 17/7/21. Total numeric is prohibited in English letters. Fine. So the way I have written the date over here, you will be writing date here, but you won't be writing the word date. You won't write date equal to 17 July. No, directly you will be writing 17 July 2021. Is it clear to everyone? Then you will skip one line again after writing the date. Again, you will skip one line and then you will be writing the receiver's address. Who is the receiver? To whom you are writing the letter. Who is the sender? You are the sender, because you are going to place the order. Fine. And receiver, to whom you are writing. And very important thing here, in receiver address, which is usually a 3-line address, fine, in consecutive 3 lines you will be writing. You won't be skipping one line in between. One receiver should be there, means you will be mentioning the designation of the person who is receiving the letter. It can be the manager, it can be the director. Fine. Any designation which is mentioned in your statement. You have to read the statement of question paper or the question very carefully. Suppose they have not mentioned any receiver, in that case you have to invent on your own. Clear? Then receiver's address, then after that beta comes the subject. Again, you will be skipping one line after receiver's address. You will write the subject then. Some students they write subject after salutation, that is also okay, but I prefer you write subject here, fine. Now the subject is about you are going to place an order. So whatever you can say topic is given in the statement, on the based of that you will be writing the subject, like placing order for sports goods, fine, placing order for musical instruments, clear? You have to place an order. Your subject, rather than, you know, we avoid writing ing words in the subject, so you can write subject to place an order for musical instruments, but it should be concise. You're not supposed to write 2-3 sentences in the subject that I want to place an order for. No, fine, to place an order for musical instruments, to place an order for sports goods, that's it. Short and crisp and clear. Then comes again, this is, you can say, not mandatory. Whether you skip a line or you don't skip a line, that doesn't matter here. That's why I'm not going to put an arrow here. Then you write dear sir. Then again in next line, from just beneath this salutation, you will start your content. Okay, now content should be in 3 paragraphs, fine, this is mandatory. Clear? Content should be in 3 paragraphs. Then comes, at last you will be writing subscription, means you will be ending your letter by writing yours truly, or you can also write yours faithfully, fine. And spelling of truly, beta, truly, most of you write true, spelling of true, and then you add ly, that is incorrect, fine. So you have to be very, very careful. Only 5 letter word it is, truly, truly. Yours truly and name. And one more thing to be added here, if your designation is given, suppose it is written that you are Bhavansh, head boy of sports club in your school. So your designation is head boy there. So you would be writing your designation just under your name. Suppose it is written you are manager of so and so company. Fine. You are manager of a company, and then your designation would be yours truly, your name, and here you will be writing manager under the name, beta, not by the side. Is it clear to everyone the format? If any doubt is there, do ask me. Is it clear? Send me thumbs up quickly. Fine, most of you are saying it is clear. So now let's talk about the paragraphs, what to write in the content. Now so we have 3 paragraphs. In paragraph number 1, you will be introducing yourself, that who you are. Clear? You will be introducing yourself. So write down, introduce yourself. Means you are the manager of a company, you are the head boy of some institution, you are director of some NGO, anything can be there. So in first paragraph, you will be telling your introduction, plus sometimes, beta, when do we place the order? Sometimes before placing the order, we make inquiry. You have done letter of inquiry also, in which we make inquiries. We ask about the rates and price list and discounts which we can avail and mode of payment, etc. Fine. So you can also start your letter by introducing yourself, and you can tell the reference number of the letter which you previously sent. Be very careful on this point. Fine. I repeat, you can mention the reference number here. Sometimes you have already written one letter to the authority. Suppose you are the manager of a club, a sports club. Fine. and you want many sports equipments for your club. Clear? So you already you have already written one letter to you can say fitness sports hub one factory, and you have asked about the prices already. So you have already made letter of inquiry. So you can also write, this is with reference to, fine, letter number this. So you can give reference to the previous letter also. Fine, this letter is with reference to the previous letter sent or dated. You can also mention the date. I will show you one example, then it will be more clear to you. So you can give your introduction, reference number of previous letter, fine, and then reason of writing letter in the first paragraph only. Clear? Three things to be covered up in first paragraph. Your introduction, then reference number, and then reason of writing. You can write that I want to place an order for various sports goods with your company. Fine. So you can tell the reason of writing the letter that you want to place an order. Then after that, in second paragraph, you will be giving the details of the objects or equipments which you want to place order for. Or you can draw a table also in second paragraph that the following items are mentioned. Mention the items. Is it visible to everyone, that table? You can mention the items that following items are required, and then you can write the serial number in first column, item name in second column, then brand in the third column, and quantity in the fourth. Suppose you want to place an order for sports equipment, then you will be writing serial number 1 and minimum 4 beta rows should be there. 4 columns and 4 rows. Remember 4x4, this formula. Remember the formula of 4x4. Means minimum 4 rows and 4 columns. But you, sometimes, you know, children, they think that the more items I would be writing, I will get more marks. Aise nahi hota hai. Fine. Sometimes children, they start writing 10 to 12 items. This is not mandatory. Minimum 4, beta, maximum 6, not more than that, remember. Clear? Columns remain 4 only, but rows can be 6, up to 6. Means more items you can add, but not more than 6. That doesn't look nice that you are just writing items only. That doesn't look like a letter only. Then after, it is not mandatory that you draw table only. You can write in sentences also if you want to place an order. Clear? That is also acceptable. Then in second paragraph, after mentioning the items, in third paragraph, you will be concluding. Firstly, you will be thanking them for extracting time. Fine. And you can tell that by which date you want the order and with how much discount you want. In last paragraph, clear? This is not the third one because that space is covered by the second paragraph only till there. So in third paragraph, conclude. Mention the date by which you want discount. You can say that hoping for huge discount, being educational institution, and then thanks. Thanks them also in third paragraph also, right? So is it clear to everyone? Finally, tell me, beta, Send me thumbs up. Dharya, yes, beta.
मैम जो सेकंड पैरा में आपने मेंशन लिखा है, मेंशन कॉमा क्या लिखा है?
मेंशन आइटम्स.
ओके मैम.
फाइन. इन सेकंड पैराग्राफ यू हैव टू एक्चुअली प्लेस एन ऑर्डर. फाइन दैट यू हैव टू मेंशन द नेम ऑफ द आइटम्स, द ब्रांड एंड द क्वांटिटी. फाइन, क्लियर? देन बेटा इफ एनी डाउट इज देयर यू कैन आस्क मी. आई वुड बी शेयरिंग द स्क्रीन and I would be showing you the various samples. Yes. Dharya, you can lower your hand better. I have given answer to your question. You can lower your hand. Okay, fine. Now, I guess we will be able to do as many examples now I would be showing. So you just keep noting down the value points, what you can add up, clear? As head of the music department of your school, write a letter to Hyderabad Music House placing an order for some music instruments. I would be telling you, you will do one letter for your homework also. So you note down this statement only. Ye wali statement note kar lo. This is your homework also. I'm going to discuss the content, but you won't be copy pasting from here. This is just for your reference that how to write a letter, because they have not even given exactly the way I have given you. They have not mentioned exactly, but yes, you can refer to this to save time. Okay. As head of the music department of your school, so your designation is head of department of music. Write a letter to Hyderabad Music House placing an order for some music instruments like sitar, harmonium, tabla, tanpura and guitar. See, how lucky you people become that most of the items are given in the statement itself. So this is the hint for you. Actually, answer is hidden in the statement. You are Anvita Anil of Dips School, Rohini, New Delhi. Clear? Your name is given. Your designation is given. Item names are also given. But what you will be adding up? You will be adding up the quantity of the objects or instruments. Fine? Or other details. So let's start. Now you won't be writing sender is Anvita and Anil, Anvita or Anil, but you won't be writing your name here. You will be writing on the behalf of your school. Fine. Diff School, Rohini, New Delhi. So beta, they have written Delhi next line, new in here. That is wrong format. Clear? So what you can do is Diff School in one line and no need to put any comma or full stop. Remember, in sender address or in receiver address also. So what you'll be doing, Diff School, Rohini, comma, New Delhi, because you have to bifurcate these two. New Delhi, fine. Then skip one line, you will be writing date. They have given wrong format, but I'm just telling you, just listen. Fine. Date, and after that skip one line, the prop writer, the owner of that, you can say, musical instrument hub. The prop writer, Hyderabad Music House. If you suppose you don't know the spelling of prop writer or you forgot it on the spot, then rather than writing, you can also write the word the manager. Fine. The manager, Hyderabad Music House, New Delhi. Clear? You need not write this code and all. PIN code you need not write. Only the manager, Hyderabad Music House, New Delhi. That's it. Fine. Then comes our subject beta. They have written subject after salutation. Both way it is correct. So you will be writing, skip one line after Delhi and then you write subject. Placement. See, I told you, you will not write placing an order. ING, you can say, is to be avoided here. So you will be writing placement of order for musical instruments. You keep noting down better side by side. Placement of order for musical instruments. Suppose it is sports goods, then your subject will be placement of order for sports goods. Now, your content starts from here. See, they have not given three paragraphs as you can see in the content, but you have to follow the formula of three paragraphs by all means. Clear? This is to inform you that our school management has decided to place an order. See, in this the child has not even introduced himself. So you would be telling that I am Anvita, or comma, head boy or head girl of Delhi, you can say Dhilwa International Public School. That is a full form of DIPS, I guess. Dhilwa International Public School, Rohini, New Delhi. Fine. And this is to inform you that our school management has decided. Firstly, you will introduce yourself. Then you will tell that this is to inform you that our school management has decided to place an order with your company. You have to use this word, with your company, not to your company. Okay. This preposition with is used here. For the supply of music instruments. Fine. You see, now I have written the code. Introduce yourself, reference number. You can also start. This is with reference to the letter number ABCIQZ21, dated 15 July 2021, in which we inquired about the rates of musical instruments. You can start that way also. But if you are confused, then you need not write reference letter. You can straight away start this way also. Clear? Introduce yourself and then reason of writing letter. What is the reason? That you want to place an order with their company. Then the price quotation submitted by your agents has been approved. Kindly note down. I asked you, I told you that you have to firstly make an inquiry and then after that we place order. So the price quotation submitted by your agents has been approved by our institution, and institutional discount of 10% is offered by you, which is accepted by us. It means firstly you are talking about the discount that you offered this and we are going to accept it. Clear? Kindly make it convenient. Now, you won't be writing this thing in the first paragraph. Not at all. Not at all. This is the third paragraph only. Clear? Fine, I'm not able to highlight it. Okay, this much. So these lines to be written at the last. Is it clear? You will be writing till here, accepted. You will be writing till here. This is your first. Fine. And then second paragraph, you will be writing the following is the details of the following are the details of the items, or we would like to place an order of the following items. Second paragraph. Then you will draw this table. Fine. They have not closed the table, but you will be making a proper table. Clear? The way we do in Excel sheet. List of items, number of pieces. You will be also writing, rather than writing number of pieces, you will be using the word quantity. Okay? Or rather than writing list of items, you will be writing item name. So you note down whatever I'm speaking. Item name, quantity, brand, and the last one was, serial number in the beginning. Clear? First column would be serial number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They have given 5 objects. Then items, sitar, harmonium, tabla, tanpura, guitar. Then number of, or you can say quantity, 5, 10, 4, 6, 2. And then brand you can mention. If you are not able to mention the brand, you're running short out of time, then you can skip the brand. Okay? But 3 columns must be there. 4th is optional. After that, beta, this is your third paragraph. Kindly make it convenient to send the. Now you're giving your priorities, that what you want while placing an order, that by which date you want, within how many days, within a fortnight or 2 weeks or 1 week. Fine. You want good packaging, that you can tell. If any damage will be done, that will be caused by the company only. Clear? And payment will be the mode of payment, that after checking the object, we will do the payment. That is also to be mentioned at the last. So this is your third paragraph. Kindly make it convenient to send the delivery within 15 days. I'm sure proper packing of the instruments will be taken care of, and the responsibility of any damage caused during transportation shall rest with you. See, this is the formal language. Rest with you doesn't mean it is going to rest. Rest with you means if any damage occurs, you will be bearing the expenses. Okay? I hope future repairs and maintenance of the pieces will be provided by you promptly and satisfactorily. The payment will be made through a crossed check to your agent just after the delivery. Fine. Then also you can write at the last, thanking you in advance, yours truly, Anvita, head of department music. This is your designation. This is the way you will be writing. Clear? Jaldi se send me thumbs up if it is clear to everyone. Divya is the first one to say, Riyanshita, Jia, Charvi, Surveen, Risham. I'm just checking those who are sitting there. Bhavansh, video to on aapne karna nahi hota, jitni baar marzi bol lo aapke. And jo 4-5 defaulters hain, holidays homework ke, beta, send it. Aapki internal assessment hai. We make sure to send it by all. This is not for us, this is for you only. So we are having, I guess, 4 minutes. Any doubt, you can raise hand and I would answer beta right now. Very important skill it is. Don't keep doubts with you. If any doubt regarding the format or the content, okay, let me ask you now, those who have raised hand. Yes, Jia, unmute yourself and tell me how many paragraphs to write in this letter. Jia Mago, kindly unmute yourself and tell me how many paragraphs are required in this letter. But why the response is not coming quickly? Okay, Pushti, can you answer this? Jia, okay, 3 paragraphs. Beta, unmute me, who aapse? Fine, Jia has sent me 3 paragraphs. Fine. Now, Pushti, you explain. What to write in the first paragraph? Unmute yourself and speak loudly. Yes, speak, beta. Pushti, boliye.
Ma'am, we have to introduce ourselves, then reference number.
Reference number is optional. Fine. Okay, no problem, Jia. It's okay. What to write in the second paragraph? Bhavansh, bataiye jaldi se.
Then we have to write the items list, quantity and serial number and brand name.
Fine, so we have to draw the table. We have to mention the items which we want to place an order for. Fine, and then what to write in the third paragraph? Who will tell? Raise your hand, come on. Kathy, can you speak? Third paragraph, what to write in third? It is written on the board only. This is just revision. Surveen, this goes to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, beta, what to write in third paragraph?
Ma'am, conclude date, discount.
Can you speak louder?
Ma'am, date, discount.
It is written there only. Conclude and tell which date, means date or days. You can mention that, send the order within fortnight or within 2 weeks or by 20th of July. You can mention the particular date. Okay. Or you can also ask about discounts. You can also talk about the way we have done this letter only. So it's clear to all of you, I guess. So we are left with only 2 minutes. Let's see one more example. So this is, you are Neha Singh, computer in charge of DIPS. Your school wishes to buy 20 computers and accessories from Apple. Nehru Place, New Delhi. This is the address of the receiver who would be receiving your letter. And you are Neha Singh of DIPS. Clear? So this is your sender address, date. Again, the receiver's address. Subject is placement of order for computers and their accessories. clear the same way you have done beta. Firstly, you will introduce yourself, then you will tell the reason of writing, then list of items. Clear? They have just mentioned like this, 25 Apple headphones, Apple laptop, 20 iPad, it in that way. But this is very small table. You need to make it, you can say more items you need to add up. So at last, kindly make it convenient to send the delivery within 15 days of the issue of this letter. Means when you send this letter, from that day onwards, till 15 days, you have to send us the order. I'm sure proper packing of the computers will be taken care of, and any responsibility for the damage caused, same thing better. Fine, damage, if caused, they will be, the expenses will be borne by the, you can say, sender. I hope future repairs and maintenance of the items will also be provided. Payment will be made after checking the order. Clear? See, order for some books for your school library. This is the way, first flight, class, quantity for your school library you are sending. Yes, Bhavansh, you have any question, beta? Okay, you have raised hand, that's it. Clear? So you are requested to send the above books as per the terms and conditions. Okay, so you need to do this one musical instrument letter, fine, in the fair notebook, and I would be sending you the test also. Next week you are having your test. I would be putting the details in the group, so keep checking. Okay, have a nice day with us.